So this morning, no, gusto lang nako i-break. I just want to break our series on Genesis, no, and I want to have a two-part series. So part one today and part two next time. No, as a sort of reflection, no, as we come, we are now in the last quarter na, no, aning a year. So it's so fast, no? Paspas kayo ang tuig ba? So we're now approaching the end of 2023. And I guess I feel like this message, two-part message is something to help us reflect on our journey. So I've given it the title Love for the Lord at the heart of everything we do. Okay? So we'll be reading from Deuteronomy 6 and Song of Songs. You might want to read Song of Songs at home, no? Basahan ninyo ang tibuok. We will only read a few passages from Song of Songs today, pero this is where I'm gonna this is what I'm gonna use, no, to deliver this message. Okay? So basahon sa nato. No, Deuteronomy 6 beginning in verse 4, "Hear, O Israel, the Lord our God, the Lord is one. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. These commandments that I give you today are to be on your hearts." Take note of the word heart, no? Balik-balik ng heart din, ha? Ang heart, magod, is at the very core, no, of a person. Okay? Impress them, no? So what's in your heart, when something is in your heart, no, it will come out, no? So if your heart is full of something, no, mugawas gid na, no? Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. Okay? Importante kayo ang heart, no? So when these things are in your heart, impress them on your children. Talk about them when you sit at home and when you walk along the road, and when you lie down and when you get up. Tie them as symbols on your hands and bind them on your forehead. Write them on the door frames of your houses and of your gates. Okay? Pero ang importante there is love the Lord your God with your whole being. No? So your heart, your soul, and your strength. Okay? And then let's jump to Song of Songs. Okay, this is a song. This is poetry. This is a love song. Okay? Beautiful. Powerful kainisya. No, so we'll just read from chapter 8, verse 6 to 7. "Place me." No, this is the girl. No, this is the woman. I think this is the woman saying this. "Place me like a seal over your heart, like a seal on your arm, for love is as strong as death. It's jealousy or ardor, unyielding as the grave. It burns like blazing fire, like a mighty flame. Many waters cannot quench love. Rivers cannot sweep it away. If one were to give all the wealth of one's house for love, it will be utterly scorned. Wag yu'y makapugong sa gugma. Walay baha, walay kalayo, wala yun. Bisan kwarta, bisan pag-ofera ni mo siya sa tanan ni mong bahandi, your bahandi will be scorned by the one in love." Grabe, no? Kisa may na-in love na dire. I'm sure most, if not all of you, have experienced being in love. And that is a very, very important kanang matter, no? That's why Solomon wrote that down here. Okay, Lord, we entrust to you this message. I pray, Lord, that through this message, our hearts will be stirred up to pursue you and seek you and to understand that above all else, we are to love you, Lord, with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. Oh Lord, tanan nga mong ginahimo, Lord, are nothing without love, oh Lord. So help us, Lord, to understand that this is really foundational, O Lord. So tanan namong mga efforts, tanan mo namong mga serbisyo are nothing without love. Help us to understand that first of all, first and foremost, we are to fall in love with you and seek you with all of our hearts. Lord, as we reflect on these things at towards the end of this year, help us, Lord, to just reorient ourselves, realign our lives, and to reset our priorities, O Lord. Thank you for your presence in this place. Thank you for the songs we sang today. Thank you because you are faithful. You are never late. You are always on time. You come even at the time we least expect because you are faithful to your promises. Thank you, Lord, in Jesus' name. Amen. Excited na mo? Okay? So, introduction nato, no? Jesus says, actually Jesus quotes, no, from that passage sa Deuteronomy, and he said, this is the first and the greatest commandment, no, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. And the second greatest commandment is like it, no, love your neighbor as yourself, di ba? So that's what he said, no, dito sa Matthew 22 and Mark 12, and also in Luke chapter 10. No, pero si Mark, take note that Mark and Luke renders it this way, no, love the Lord your God with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength. Giad nila ang mind, okay? Because sa Hebrew, sa Old Testament, wala ang mind, because the Hebrews do not compartmentalize, no, the soul, the mind, okay, and the spirit. Para sa ilaha, they look upon it as one. No, pero si Mark magud og si Luke, they were writing at a time when Greek was the culture. Greek was the language. And ang Greek thought manggod distinguishes the mind. In fact, kita karon, now we in our generation, we are Greek thinkers. No, muna natay academics. Academic man ta when we process information. No? Pero ang mga Hebrew dili ana, no? Isa ra na, sagol ra na tanan. Okay? So muna na appeal din ha ang mind. Actually, what they're saying is love the Lord your God with your entire being. No? So sa ato ang understanding karon, because we're Greek thinkers, the entire being of man, no, includes the heart, soul, mind, and strength. Okay? So this is what Christianity and serving God is all about. Actually, okay? Mauni ang pag-serve sa Ginoo. No, mauni ang pundasyon yun sa pag-serve sa Ginoo. Not so much even like serving, doing good works, no? Secondary rana, no? In fact, ang amo ang founder sa APIS, no? Si Dr. Paul Chu said, dito sa isa na mo ka lecture, the chief purpose of man is to glorify God and to enjoy Him forever. Amen? Mauna ang Christianity. No? You love God, you are in relationship with God, you want to glorify Him, and you enjoy Him forever. Tanan imong ginahimo is because you are in love with God. Okay? Kung daghantang gihimo nga mga serbisyo nga walay gugma sa Ginoo, useless na tanan. Amen? So we need to be reminded of that as we come to the end of this year. So bisan asa ka igsoon, whatever you're doing, no, whether nag-ministry, whether nag-business, whether naka sa balay, whatever you do, estudyante man ka, as long as you do it together with your love for God, no, what you do matters to Him. Amen? So, kinahanglan nato ma-align, tanan natong ginahimo, dapat inspired gina by our love for God. No? So Lord, estudyante ko, ayuhon gina ko akong pagka-estudyante, I want to be excellent in school because I'm not doing it for my mother lang or for myself, para musikat ko, pero I'm doing this for you, Lord. I want to excel because I love you. And I want to glorify you, Lord, here in school. Kana bitaw nga mga klase nga attitude, no? Or your sa imong trabaho, Lord, na mo ni ako ang workplace, I want to excel in my workplace, not just to get a promotion, pero mo excel gid ko, Lord, because I'm serving you. I'm not just serving my boss, I'm serving you, Lord, because I love you. Kana bitaw, no? Inana? Okay? So, mumater na atubangan sa Ginoo. Our service does not flow out of duty, out of rules, or out of religion. Amen? Okay? So, dapat ma-remind natong kaugalingon nga ingonana ang atuang service. We serve God because we have fallen in love with Him. Amen! Amen. Okay, so mao ni akong giingon, no? Mag-reflect lang tagamay mga igsoon. End of year, reflection na to. Reflect on what you have learned from the Bible so far. Daghan matang gihisgutan diri sa church, no? Sa atong mga Bible studies. I-reflect daw. Reflect on your journey. Kumusta man ang imong journey? Okay, so sa tanan imong natunan, tanan imong Bible study, tanan imong mga gipang-atinan, no? How has it affected your journey, no? Grow ba ka sa imong journey with the Lord? No, reflect also on your personal development. Ning develop pa pod ka personally. Ning increase ba ang character, ang Christ-likeness na to? Okay, ni increase ba ang ato ang love for the Lord? No, kumusta ang atong personal relationship with the Lord? Have I fallen in love with the Lord? Or have I fallen out of love na with the Lord? No, so i-reflect na, Lord, na what an naman kog first love? Sa una, dasig man kaay ko sa imo. Karon boring. So I need to recapture my first love. Okay? So mauna ang sentiment, no, ni Jesus Christ dito sa Book of Revelation, no, one of the churches. To one of the churches, he wrote, "No, I have this against you. You have forsaken your first love." Okay? So, i-reflect daw nato igsoon, no? So, diri sa TGFM, daghan tag na-learn, no? Daghan magutag mga pagtulunan din, eh. Nagtuon ta sa Pentateuch. Na-discover nato nga God is King. He is extending His kingdom to the whole earth. And He wants us to be part of it, no? So, gwapo ni nga mga learnings, no? Importantin kaayo ni nga mga learnings. Because they help us serve the Lord, no, and participate in His purpose. No, nya natun-an nato that the Pentateuch points to the end times, the last days. And we know last days naman karon, no? So ang Pentateuch, atong five books ni Moses, is pointing to our time today, no? And we are now living in that time pointed by the Pentateuch. Okay? So natuna. And the Bible, so actually ang Bible is about the end times pod, no? The Bible is about eschatology. It's about the end times, the last things. Okay? Kaya ang Genesis is already pointing to the last things. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, pointing to the end times. Okay? So we can say the Bible is also a book about the end times. Okay, in fact, sa Pentateuch, ako man ni, I don't know kung naka-remember pa mo, nagsugod ang Pentateuch in the beginning, di ba? Mao man ang phrase ni Moses. And then, dito towards the end, sa Pentateuch, sa Deuteronomy, nagamit na po siya lain nga phrase, in days to come. No, kana nga mga words, importante na. In the beginning, and then in days to come. No, so, ang Pentateuch points to the days coming. And then as you progress, you're reading in the Bible, you go to the prophets, you go to the Psalms, you will encounter similar phrase. No, ma-encounter ni muna sa prophets, ang common nga phrase imong ma-encounter is in the last days, di ba? Daghan mga propeta gagamit ana, no, sila Isaiah and the other prophets, no, in days to come, or in that day, or on that day, or in the time of the end, no, si Daniel mao na ang iyang gigamit nga phrase, in the time of the end, still pointing to the last days. Kanus man ang last days karon? New Testament is the last days. When Jesus arrived, that's the last days. That's the beginning of the last days. Kana. So ang mga apostles in the New Testament, they now use this phrase. Gikan na dito sa Genesis pa, no, last days. Si Jesus, ang paborito niya nga phrase is the end. Okay? This gospel of the kingdom will be preached in the whole world as a testimony to all nations, and then the end shall come. No, that's what Jesus said, Matthew 24:14. Okay? Or end times, no? Sa inyong Bible, na ay headings, diha, section headings, kung tanaw ninyo sa New Testament, na ay mga headings na kabutang din ha, end times. Okay? Kanang end times, wala gid na sa Bible verses. Dito ka na sa headings. Pero it's talking about the last days. Okay? So, nakatkaton ta aning mga butanga, no? We learned about the Bible and God's purpose. And this is great learning, di ba? Gwapo man eh, maayo man eh, nga learning. Pero we must remember. Kinahanglan lagi ta maka-remember. Jesus said, above all else, we are to love the Lord our God with all our heart, soul, mind, and strength, with our whole being. Dili nato na siya kalimtan. Amen? So, i-reflect nato na, Lord, i-process nato na tanan, Lord, na anak ko sa last days, Lord, tabangi ko to love you with all of my heart, soul, mind, and strength in these last days. Lord, daghan kaayong maka-distract na ko, no? Daghan kaayong mga distractions, daghan kaayong mga mag-seduce na ako, mag-allure na ako, mag-tintal na ako. Help me, no, as I struggle through these last days, help me to remain true to you, love you with all of my being. Okay, so let's just talk a little bit about this whole idea of loving the Lord with the heart, okay? So, unahon sa nato ang heart. Okay. So, ang Pentateuch, ang kings, ang prophets, ang revelation, what they do is they show us God's purpose. Pero there are other books in the Bible, no, particularly the wisdom literature. Actually, ang wisdom literature is found at the very center of the Bible. Lima niya siya ka books found at the very center of our Bible. So, matawag na ito nga heart of the Bible. What do they teach us? They teach us to love God. So, importante po ta magbasa aning lima ka wisdom literature books. Okay? What are these? Kinsa kabalo? Kung sa maning wisdom literature nga books? Okay, Proverbs is part of that. Unsa pa? Psalms? Ha? Song of Songs? Unsa pa? Hinay kayo. Okay, Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, and Song of Songs. Okay? Kanang lima. They teach us to love the Lord. Pero out of the five, ang pinakasintro gidana nila is Song of Songs. No, mao gina siya ang magtudlo nato how to really love the Lord with all of our heart. Okay, that's what we look at today. Next part, part 2, tunan nato itong other 4, no? How they teach us to love the Lord. So, tunan sa nato ni. So, wisdom literature, mao ni, no? Job, Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, Song of Songs. They are all poetry. Okay? Nganong poetry man, emotional magud ang poems. Okay? That's why when we write songs, songs are about emotions. No, you're not supposed to dissect poetry, no, mabuang ka kung imong i-dissect ang poetry, no, like you are dissecting law or mga teachings. No, poetry, you just listen to it and listen to what the heart is say, communicating, no, in the poetry. Okay, so they talk about loving God and they all involve emotions. Amen. Okay, so sa Christian life, kinahanglan di ita emotional. Okay? Now, mao ni ang problema nato karon. Because we have been influenced by Greek thought. Ang Greek thought manggod is academic. Okay? Daghan naguna-una ang Christian nga to love the Lord is to study about the Lord. Muna, daghang Bible study, seminar. Academic man na. No, pero loving the Lord involves the emotions. Okay? So, mao ni ang na-miss nato karon, no, sa present-day Christianity. Okay, so importante ni siya igsuon. No, that's why Mark said and Luke said, with all your heart. Heart gyud ang giuna diha. Because from the heart flows out everything. Okay, if the Lord captures your heart, then assured na siya that He has all of you. Okay, pero kung wala gani imong heart, you may give to the Lord your strength, you may give the Lord your mind, pero your heart is not there. Okay? Ang gipangita sa Ginoo is your heart. Amen? Okay? Out of the emotional heart flows all things. Okay? So sa atong pagkakristohanon, kinahanglan gitag emosyon. When we praise and worship here in church, please express yourself. No, be emotional sa praise and worship. Mobi to nga idim na to ang suga kay para matagaan mo gamay nga privacy. Kay para kung muhilak mo, di kay mo maulaw. Okay? Pero please express yourself during worship, no? Do not treat praise and worship nga ay kanta-kanta ka man na. No, nagkuha na na, palipas oras ra na hantod mo abot ang sermon. Sayop na siya nga thinking, no? Importante sa ato sa TGFM ang praise and worship. Okay? All of us are passionate about some things, di ba? Passionate man ka about something. Ang uba na to, passionate about negosyo. Ang uba na to, passionate about social media. Ang uba na to, passionate about sports. Passionate man ka about something. Ngunya, basta ang passion ni mo always involves emotion, di ba? If you're passionate about something, emotional man ka ana. No? Invested ka ana, no? When you are passionate about something, no? Passion captures your whole being, soul, mind, and strength, no? Making you fully invested in that which you are passionate about, di ba? Ang uba ninyo, passionate sa inyong boyfriend or sa inyong girlfriend. Invested good ka ana, tanan nimong allowance to adito. Oh. Oh, tanan nimong oras. No, pati imong damgo to pa dito invested si kag damgo sa iya. Because you're passionate about him or her. Okay, mo gid na if you're passionate about something, it's emotional. Amen. And the Lord wants you to be passionate towards him. Amen. Mauna nga gisulat ang Song of Songs. Love story. Okay? Tanaw na to naron. Why? Basahon na to ni. 1, 2, 3. God wants our heart. One more time. God wants our heart. Because when He has your heart, then He has all of you. Everything of you. Diba? Okay. So, ang ako sigong mensahe diri kanang mga igsuon, let's fall in love with the Lord. Kanaragid, simple ra akong mensahe karon, no? Karon nga year, toward padulong na tag-Disembre, no? Lord, tabangi ko to fall in love with you all over again. Lord, nga di ko malingaw nga kang Santa Claus na ko ma-in love. Huwag sa mga gift na ko ma-in love. Okay. Much of Christianity today focuses on loving the Lord with our mind. Greek lagi. And strength. No, muna, mag-study ta, no? Bible study, academic ba? Doing good works, performing services. And many of us neglect loving the Lord emotionally, which was part of the Hebrew understanding of love. Amen? So, dasigunta mo igsoon, stir up your emotions toward God, no? Ang uban nato moingon ta nga ay di man ko emotional. I disagree. Because you are emotional about something. Mao lagi if you're passionate about something, emotional man ka diha. So dili ko mutuo nga you are not an emotional person. Kay you are able to express emotion no dito sa imong areas of passion. So if you're able to do that, why not towards God? Okay? So emotions are very important in the Bible. This is why so much of the Bible was written in poetry. No, more than 1/3 of the Bible is poetry. No, ang mga prophets halos poetry na tanan. Ang prophets, no, wisdom literature and the prophets. Why? Because poetry involves the heart. No, the heart of the writer ug ang heart sa listener. No, ang poetry. Okay? Now, when you study poetry, ayaw lagi ninyo i-dissect, no? Ayaw i-analyze, no? Mabuang ka kung mag-dissect ka sa poetry. Just listen to it, no? In fact, gi-encourage me sa amuang katungin akong gi-eskwelahan, no? Sa APIS to listen to the Bible, no? So, ako ning gina-practice for several months now, no? Kay ga-walking man ko mabuntag, no? Halos every other day. Except lang pagbalik na mo sa Thailand, naputol na ko, sige ako kaon. Pero sa pila na ko ka, mga 2 months masiguro na akong walking-walking, nga maminaw ko, audio Bible, daghan akong books na human ba? Oh, nahuman ako ang Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, nahuman ako, Daniel, no, Ezekiel, daghan kong nahuman. Yeah, nindot man ay maminawon ang kuano, ang Bible, audio Bible. No, nasa inyong cellphone. Okay, you can listen to it as you travel or whatever. Okay, or exercise. Okay? God is an emotional God. That's why he speaks in poetry. Okay? So he expresses himself to his people through poetry. No, so makita nimo sa iyang writing sa poetry ang anger sa Ginoo, no, ang iyang retribution, ang iyang judgment, ang iyang disappointment is what niya dito, disappointed gid ko ninyo. No, nagtanom ko og vineyard unsa man wa gi koy nakuha. Okay, iyang frustration and also his longing for the love of his people. Pati dito ang iyang compassion, no, ang iyang joy over his people. Gi-express na siya tanan sa Ginoo through poetry. No, through the wisdom literature and through the prophets, okay? Kay emotional gid ang Ginoo towards sa ato, no? So he wants us to respond to him emotionally also. Okay? So basahon nato ni 1 2 3. Before we can serve God effectively, we need to learn to love him emotionally and grow deeper in this love. So hagiton ti kaigsoon, please fall in love with the Lord. Maybe you will tell me, I already forgot how it is to fall in love. Basing kinahanglan ka mo, pagpatabang siguro kag Korean drama para matudluan ka what it is like to fall in love. Okay, sige. So we need to fall in love with God, unsa may angayon mahitabo, no, we need to experience God's love, forgiveness and goodness first. Kinahanglan gyud nimo na ma-experience igsoon. No, and then when you experience that, you will fall in love with him. Okay, mao man ang good news, no, nga we are sinners and deserving gyud ta to enter the kingdom, deserving gyud ta to go to hell. No, daghan kay tag sala, dako kay atong sala, pero Jesus forgives us of our sin. No, that's the good news. No, he wants you to know you are forgiven. No, if you believe in him, you are forgiven of all your sins. And you are given the freedom to serve the Lord, no, in his kingdom. Good news na, no. So kinahanglan nimo na ma-experience. Dili enough na tun-an nimo na academically in a Bible study. You need to experience that personally for yourself, so that you will fall in love with the Lord, no? Mao bitaw sometimes i-allow sa Ginoo ang ato ang mga problema so that we can call on him, and when we see him rescue us, we will fall in love with him. Okay? So kini nga atong mga problema usahay opportunity na for us to know our God more. Okay? So love the Lord, kanang fear of the Lord, kanang serving the Lord, no? All of these need to come from this place of emotional, passionate love for God in our heart. Okay? So kinahanglan nato na maabot ka na siya nga place of loving the Lord, no? And then i-express nato na ang ato ang fear of the Lord from that place. Okay. So otherwise, kung wala manggod tay love, emotional love for the Lord, dali ra gyud ta ma-distract. No? Dali ra ta madala sa TikTok, dali ra ta madala sa bisan unsa. No? Dali ra ta madala sa photo lab. Oh. Now, wala biya mi nag-judge anang photo lab, ha? So, kung imuhan ng kalipay, sige, suportaan ka na mo, ampuan ka na mo din, ha? So, no judgment, no? Let's allow people to enjoy. Enjoy man ang mga tao, ana, no? Curious ba yata, what would I look like kung inani akong body? So pero ako wala sa ako nagpatintal adi sa ako siguro. So okay lang na enjoy ko sa inyong mga photo labs. Song of Songs, tanaw nato ning Song of Songs ha. Okay, this is as I said at the very heart of loving God. This is a love song. It's highly emotional, even a bit sexually graphic. Okay, so may pagka-R-rated pagani siya gamay. Okay, so pero naa na siya sa Bible. No, dili na siya dirty. So mo na ang problema karon, no? Because the world has put sex in that light. Nga ang sex is dirty, no? Pero dili man amao ang original nga intent. God created sex good. Okay? In fact, importante na siya, naana siya important pictures, no, sa kingdom of God. Okay? So, Song of Songs, gitawag siya nga Song of Songs because it is the greatest song of Solomon. Okay, the Hebrews even considered this song very sacred. In fact, during the Passover feast, no, sa kanang Sabbath day, anak nga Passover, they read Song of Songs. Okay? So, ganun, basahon man nila during Passover. Naarap ang mga bata, diha. Basahon nila na because they understand, no, that it is an analogy and type of God's love for His people. Okay? So, magbasa sila na walay Malaysia, no, dili pareha sa ato nga na napulyot na atong mind because of what we saw on the internet. So, hugaw na atong tanawan na, malisyoso na atong tinanawan na, no, pero dili man ko na siya ingon ana. Okay, it is an analogy and type of God's love for His people. Location in the Bible, it is right at the very center of your Bible. No, check your Bible, naa na siya sa tunga. Okay, ngano man, but pasabot ana, it is intimacy with God is at the center, is the center or heart of Christianity. Okay, mao na nga sa sentro na siya gibutang. Okay. Tanaw nato ning Song of Songs. So basahon lang nato no some verses direct. Oh, let him kiss me with the kisses of his mouth. Woo! For your love is more delightful than wine. Pleasing is the fragrance of your perfumes. Your name is like perfume poured out. No wonder the young women love you. This is the girl speaking, no? Okay. Dark am I, yet lovely. Daughters of Jerusalem, dark like the tents of Kedar, like the tent curtains of Solomon. No, so kining girl ani is dark-skinned ni siya. Okay? Kuan ni siya, lover ni siya. Girlfriend ni Solomon, okay? Do not stare at me because I am dark. Because I am darkened by the sun. My mother's sons were angry with me and made me take care of the vineyards. My own vineyard I had to neglect. Tell me, you whom I love, where you graze your flock and where you rest your sheep at midday. Why should I be like a veiled woman beside the flocks of your friends? The woman does not know that Solomon is king, no, because he went there in the countryside disguised as a shepherd. Okay, and he fell in love with this dark-skinned woman. Okay, so mao na ang nahitabo ana, no? So love story gid ni siya, no? Wala kalibutan ang babae at first nga king di ay ang nanguyab niya. Okay, now let's go to chapter 4. You have stolen. This is now the guy, no, speaking. Solomon, you have stolen my heart, my sister, my bride. You have stolen my heart with one glance of your eyes, with one jewel of your necklace. How delightful is your love, my sister, my bride. How much more pleasing is your love than wine, and the fragrance of your perfume more than any spice. Okay? And then jump ta dito sa chapter 6. This is now the woman. She was dreaming. Nag-dream siya. Kay nag-long man siya na magkita sila sa iyang lover. I slept, but my heart was awake. Listen, my beloved is knocking. Open to me, my sister, my darling, my dove, my flawless one. My head is drenched with dew, my hair with the dampness of the night. I have taken off my robe. Must I put it on again? I have washed my feet. Must I soil them? Nag-ilis naman ko, ablihan pati ka? Huh? Gana ba? So, pero later on, kay giablihan gid niya, my beloved thrust his hand through the latch opening, my heart began to pound for him. I arose to open for my beloved and my hands dripped with mirror, my fingers flowing with mirror on the handles of the bolt. I opened for my beloved, but my beloved had left and he was gone. Oy, nawala na. Dugay-dugay, magbukan yung bakod. My heart sank at his departure. I looked for him but did not find him. I called him but he did not answer. Niatugit siya sa syudad, no? The watchman found me as they made their rounds in the city. They beat me, they bruised me. They took away my cloak, those watchmen of the walls. Daughters of Jerusalem, I charge you, if you find my beloved, what will you tell him? Tell him I am faint with love. Wow! Kuyaw! Okay, and then chapter 8, mo ni atong gibasa ganina, no? So place me like a seal over your heart, no? So many waters cannot quench love. Basta mag-uros-uros na laging gugma, di na ginamapugnan, no? Bisan pagkamatayon, no? Why makapugong? Mudas-das gid na kay gugma lagi. Now, inana po doon ta atong gugma kang Kristo. No, nabisan kamatayon, why makapugong? Kay grabe man atong gugma, oros-oros man kang Kristo. Ana unta? Okay, mo na ang point ba? And the Jews understood the analogy. Okay? So, the analogy employed by Solomon here is not the love of a son to a father. Dili po siya love of a subject to a king or a love of a friend to another friend. Pero specific yun nga love ang iyang gibutang dinhi to teach us how to love God, no? He uses the love of a man for his girlfriend or lover and vice versa. Okay? Solomon uses the analogy of romantic and physical love to show us how God loves us and how we are to respond to God's love. So, nangita gid ang Ginoog lalom nga intimacy. Okay? So, of course, we relate to God as subject to king. Naman tayo inana nga mga situation, no? Nga, I serve you, God, you are my king. Nana siya inana. Or we say, Lord, you are my father. No, I really reverence you, God, my father. No, pero he wants a deeper kuan, intimacy sa atoa, no, like a lover. Okay? And he wants us to respond that way, no? So the Bible also frequently uses the analogy of the love of a husband and wife to depict our love relationship with God. Daghan po na siya sa mga prophets nga tawagon kita nga iyang wife o iyang bride, no? Pero here sa Song of Solomon, specific gyud siya nga ang analogy gyud diri is lovers in love. Kana gyud nga kuan. Okay? Kay usahay man gud ang husband ug wife, napalong na ang pagka-in love. The flames of love have died down. Sige mag-away. Sige magbugno, sige maglalis, no? So usahay mo mapahong. Kinala na pud i-rekindle ang gugma. Pero what the Lord is looking for is a passionate love nga dito nimo makita during courtship ba, no, sa pagpanguyab. Okay? So what is the song about? It is about two people, not three. Usahay magbasa kahala, tulo lagi ni duha lagi ni kalaki. Actually dili, no. A king who was the shepherd like a person and who was the shepherd like person and a girl. The king and the shepherd here are one person. Okay? Kay nag-disguise man si Solomon as a shepherd, no, as he went to the countryside. Si Solomon man good scientist ba ni siya, di ba? He wants to study the birds, the animals, the plants. So he goes to the countryside to study. He disguises himself as a shepherd and there he met, no, this simple and dark-skinned farm girl, no, and he fell in love with her. Iyahang gisuyo niya, no, gipurso niya. The girl did not know who he was and one day he promised to marry her but said that he had to go to the city first to settle some matters, no. So ang girl was waiting for him to come back. No, ito nga, nagdamgo na lang kadugayan ang babae. No? Kano sa siya mubalik? No, significant part of the song was about her waiting and her dream of going to Jerusalem to look for him. Hearing a knock on the door in her dream and discovering he was gone by the time she got up. No, so unfulfilled longing. No, ay, nawala na ang the one I love. So, iyang gipangita, wagin niya nakitaan. So, nag-increase ang pangandoy. One day, he returned, married her, and brought her back to Jerusalem. And then, the last part sa kuan was about the banquet, no? And love songs with mentions of physical love. Pagyod na din na appeal. Okay? So, mauna, that's what it is about. Okay? So, kini nga pangutana. Be, tubagan ninyo. Unsa may mahitabo sa usa ka tawo kung ma-in love? Kay ang tubag ani nga pangutana will help us understand how we are to love Christ. Okay? Ang tubag ani, I mean, so many of us, if not all of us, have a bit of an understanding ani. No, kay at some point in your life na in love ka or na kay crush, bahalag unrequited love, basta na kay crush, you felt the feelings, you went through the emotions, okay? So makarelate ka ani. Okay? So katong mga dugay-dugay nang naminyo, sige na mugaway. Dumduma daw balik nagunsa to inyohang kuan, courtship ninyo. Okay? Oh, para ma-refresh ka, tanawa sa Korean drama, para ma-refresh. Okay. Be, sa may mga answer, be? Ha? Agbay. Nag-ride og bike? Ah, mabaka. So, daghan mahitabo, no? Actually, nag-gilista na ako ang uban dire, no? Daghan pang wala ma-appeal dire, pero ilista lang ako some of the things nga common nga masabta na to, no? So, kung ma-inlove ang usa ka tao, you can stop thinking about the other person, no? Sige, kaguna ako na sa iya, ha? Okay? You dream about. Madamguhan na lang appeal, no? Okay? Can't wait to see him or her again, di ba? You want to spend much time with him or her? Sakto ba? You want to talk, no, with him or her? You love to listen to the other person talk? You love to watch or stare at the other person? No, so mga inana, no? Mao man pud ni unta dapat kung in love ta kang Jesus, no? No, you can't stop talking about Jesus. No, we can't kuan, stop thinking about him. We want to do things together. No, you can't stop talking about him or her. You defend him or her, even fight for him or her. You want to say romantic words. You want to do romantic things to express emotions. You become so corny. Others say, ew. You do crazy things, no? Para na nga person, no? Say, makabuang ang gugma, no? Oh. Romantic love is 95 to 100% emotions and almost 0% reason. Di ba? Oh. Makabuang gid lagi daw ning gugma. Okay? Makabugo po daw ang gugma. Kay mabulok man gid daw ang ato ang reasoning kung nahigugma na. Okay. Pero you do not enter romantic love academically. Dili ba ta academic? We go enter it emotionally, di ba? Oh, dili man ka mag-analyze. Ang imong mata is 2 cm from the diri. Ang angle sa imong nose is, di ba ni mo na i-analyze yun, ana, nga academic? No, ang color sa imong hair, yung ani nga shade. Dili man, ana, no, you just enter into it emotionally, no, and get swept away by the emotions. Okay? So, ingon ana ba? Okay? So, you go on a emotional roller coaster, no, because of the person. You practically grow crazy, head over heels, become a fool, no, because of the person. So, maupo na sa Bible, no? Kung in love ka kan Jesus, you become a fool for Christ, no? We are out of our mind, no, sa ato ang faith kang Jesus, di ba? So, mauna appropriate kayo ni siya nga analogy, no, for falling in love. And then romantic love ideally leads to marriage. And love in marriage produces children. So, mauna ni ang padulngan good. Okay, so ang Kristohanon nga na in love gid kang Jesus ultimately will produce spiritual children. Okay? So, mauna. So, Christians who think loving God is academic, no, will complete all the seminars, read all the books, go through all the trainings, pero dili gyud makaanak, makaproduce og spiritual children. Because we have gone through it academically. Okay? So, we need to begin with the heart. Amen? So on, you need to fall in love. We need to fall in love with the Lord. And everything will just follow. Okay? Okay, so have you fallen in love with the Lord? Are you still in love with the Lord? Or have you forsaken your first love? No? So mauna ang mga kinahanglan nato i-reflect sa atong kinabuhi. No, key lessons from Song of Solomon. Number one, God is an emotional God. And He wants us to be emotional towards Him. Okay, so stir up igsoon. Be expressive. Be emotional towards God. Pagandoy, Lord, gusto ko nga mag-emotional sa imo, Lord. I want to be expressive towards you. I want to be open to you, Lord. Okay, our passionate love for God should be at the center of our faith. Everything done simply. Ato ning basahon ning number three. This is so important. Number three. One, two, three. Everything done simply out of duty means nothing to God. If we have no love, we are nothing but noisy cymbals, according to 1 Corinthians 13:1. Amen? So, dapat dito kita magsugod sa ato ang pagka-inlove sa Ginoo. God wants us to fall in love with Him personally and intimately. God wants us to love Him with passion. God wants to teach us that sex is created by Him and we need to have a biblical view of it. No, that's why important itong seminar ni Delora, no? So I encourage you, no? Check that out, no? Kanang palista mo, appeal mo anak nga seminar. Nindot na siya, important na siya sa ato karon. Okay, as the year 2023 comes to a close, let us pursue loving the Lord deeper emotionally, and let us return to our first love. Amen ba mga igsoon? So, baliko na ko ang giingon ni Paul Chu, the chief purpose of man is to glorify God and enjoy Him forever. No? So, mao na itong unahon igsoon. Coming up next, no, next part to ani, mao niya itong hisgutan, no, growing deeper in love with God in the other aspects. Sa pagkakaroon, we just spoke about emotions, no? Pero na may laing aspeto sa atong kinabuhi, no? And Job talks about that. Psalms, Proverbs, Ecclesiastes, dunay mga pagtulunan ni nga mga wisdom books on the other aspects, no, of our loving the Lord. Amen.